Go on.
Yeah, whatever.
Second date update.
That guy's a cheater.
I'm just manifesting.
Ooh, it's Confession Wednesday.
Tell us your secrets.
It's the John and Chantel Radio Podcast.
It's a podcast?
It's a podcast.
Oh.
John and Chantel's Radio Podcast.
It's Friday!
Oh, I can't believe it.
You did it. Congratulations. If this was your first week back at school, it's through.
You made it.
Yes, let's all take a deep sigh of relief together. Hey, you know, I played this game like last week, maybe 2 weeks ago for those, Sam Smith tickets. I had it, but we never played it again, and I grabbed all this audio. Pop classics on the piano. You remember that?
Yes, I was terrible at it.
You were. Let's see how well you do today. Here you go. Artist and song. Classics on the piano, like that's my favorite part about like Bridgerton, is when they do like,
yeah,
it's like so cool. Got it?
Nothing? I can't, the name, I don't know. I know the song. It's
As It Was by Harry Styles.
Yes. All
right. How about this one?
Okay.
This might be the hardest one. We played this forever. Forever. T-Waves.
Wow, that's hard. No.
Yeah, I know. I couldn't get that one either. I could not get that one. One more.
Okay.
Whoever won those Sam Smith tickets should be glad I didn't play these ones. There you go.
Adele.
Yeah. Which Adele song?
I heard, hey, you settle down.
Someone like you.
Yeah.
Someone like you. Nice job. You at least ended strong. Started just terrible. Oh, you said well.
Well, it's Adele, so.
All right, we'll do a quote. We'll kick off the show. If you fell down yesterday, stand up today. H.G. Wells said that.
Yeah,
if you fell down, that was yesterday. Today's a new day. What are you going to do? Get on up.
Let's do it. Let's talk what's trending. It's Friday. I'm so excited about it. And you want to know what's so cool? We have something to look forward to, like Taco Tuesday. As you know, Jack in the Box is taking their Taco Tuesday to the next level. The restaurant is offering 2 free tacos with any purchase you make on a Tuesday. Taco John's has also surrendered its trademark on the phrase Taco Tuesday after a battle with Taco Bell.
Yeah, everyone's doing Taco Tuesday now because they don't have the trademark anymore. You know what's crazy? Huh. There's all that excitement about the Jack in the Box opening.
Yeah, the one over there in Salt Lake.
I haven't been yet.
I haven't been yet because the line is still so long.
Is it?
Yes, every time I've driven by, there's been a line, and all I want are my tacos.
I want 2 tacos for it. It's no longer 99 cents.
Maybe I'm
going
to go do that today.
Sounds good. Oh, man.
Oh, it sounds so good.
I love Jack in the Box. And no. I know I haven't been there and I just said that, but
They're so good.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to do that today. Look what you did to me. No. Other exciting news. We've got 2 new singles out today and I am stoked. Yeah. Miley Cyrus released this new song. It's called Used to Be Young.
I know it used to be crazy. I know it used to be fun. You say it used to be wild. I say it used to be young.
So good. There's like Miley is incredible.
The music video of her just staring into the camera and she's like that one tear going down her cheek. I'm like, it's fantastic.
She's amazing.
Yeah, it is.
And then also Selena Gomez released this one. It's called Single Soon.
I'm picking out this dress, trying on these shoes, cause I'll be single soon.
I want to know more. I want to know the backstory.
Everything that they do, I love. And I know I'm their generation. Like, yeah. I grew up with them. Like, we're very similar in age. Yeah. Like, but the songs that they release are just so good to me. And the most exciting thing is that Corn Bellies is back, obviously. It's not open yet, but they've been in making announcements about Corn Bellies. I bought my season passes last week. Me and my kids, we are going to be there all fall long. And the big announcement, the theme for Corn Bellies over there in Spanish Fork, Reba.
Hi, this is Reba McEntire, and I'd like to personally invite you to come get lost in this year's Country Music Corn Maze, featuring yours truly.
How did they get Reba?
How do they get Reba to make a private special announcement that her face, Reba's face, is going to be a corn maze in Spanish Fork, Utah?
Shout out to Corn Bellies for being able to pull that. That's huge.
I am so excited. And what's cool about the Spanish Fork Corn Bellies is it actually opens in September because they do the Sunflower Festival.
Oh, that's right.
I know. So I will be there probably, I don't know the opening date, but I'm going to be there to get my Reba on and get my sunflowers. I'm so excited. That's what's trending.
John and Chantel's Hot Topic.
Okay.
It's a daily poll. We put it up on Instagram at Mix1051 Utah.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully you follow us. It's been a problem that I've been experiencing this summer. I've been going over to Vasa, working out.
Yeah?
Trying to get in shape before the school year when, I just gain all the weight back.
Okay.
Every time, Chantel, I've been at the gym, someone has been talking on the phone.
Okay.
And I think it is just unacceptable. I mean, honestly, I'm like, what kind of consideration do you have for everyone else at the gym where you feel like you should be just having your own conversation in the middle of this place?
What's the difference between them talking on the phone and them talking to a person?
I don't like loud conversation at the gym either. I had two guys yesterday. They just were catching up. I hate it.
It sounds to me like you need a private gym.
You're right. I do.
Who do we talk to about this?
I'm like, come on, stop it. Get off the phone. You're working out. Stop having social hour. You're working out.
As long as they're not hoarding equipment, it's fine.
If you're talking, you're not working out hard enough.
Okay.
You should be sounding like this the whole time. Like you're about to have a heart attack. That's how I sound when I'm at the gym.
Because you're about to have a heart attack.
Yes. I just find it to be, it's rude.
I feel uncomfortable. Like if I go out to lunch and have my AirPods in and I'm talking, I'll always say, oh, let me call you back. I'm going in to grab food.
Yeah.
But then people will sit at their table with their AirPods in, eating lunch and talking to someone.
I don't like it.
And it looks to me, I'm like, it looks like I'm talking to myself. I don't
also,
like it.
People talk louder on the phone,
right,
with the earbuds.
Right.
Than they do if they have someone
you can't
sitting
hear
across. Yeah.
How loud you be.
I'm like, I don't need to hear your story, Stacey.
But do you?
Well, if it's good, I'll
you
listen
might.
In.
Like, people want to hear my stories.
Like, if you're having a complete meltdown and you're screaming into the phone, I want to be a part of that.
Oh, yeah.
But otherwise, no.
When you're talking to... If the phone call begins with, speak to a representative, I am locked in.
I can't wait to see how today's goes, because I think there are people, like you, who have now decided it's socially acceptable to be on the phone talking loud. I hate walking through Target and seeing someone on a FaceTime call. I was at Shields the other day. And someone was FaceTiming going down the escalator. And I'm like, really?
Where does it stop?
Like, can't you just go to Shields? Do you need someone to be talking to you the whole time? Also, you're going to fall off that escalator.
Yeah.
And I'll laugh at you.
Yeah.
Talking on the phone at the gym. Rude or not. Go to Instagram at Mix1051 Utah.
Why are you yelling?
I've got some good news.
I've got some very good news.
Whoa, I definitely want to hear about that.
And now, the moment you've been waiting for.
My good news and your good news.
Let's go. It's Friday. That's good news right there. The odds of this story are insane. Two kids got adopted separately by the same family in Staten Island 2 decades ago.
Oh.
And they just found out they're biological siblings.
Oh, they didn't know?
Their names are Frank and Victoria. He's 22. He got adopted after someone left him on the steps of a daycare. Oh. A year and a half later, the same couple adopted Victoria. She was found abandoned in a hospital bathroom. I mean, these two stories alone just make your heart, like, break.
Right.
Their adoptive parents didn't tell them the full story until a few months ago, and they recently decided to take DNA tests to see if they had any family out there. When they got the results, they found out they are 100% full biological siblings. I mean, same mother and father. Even the adoption agency had no idea. Here they are talking about it.
I got the match that my brother had popped up as my full sibling, my biological brother, which was definitely something crazy and not really expected at all.
We were both
found a year and a half apart and wound up in the same family, the odds are insane.
That's crazy.
Yeah, I love everything about that story. I really do. There's a Boston woman with Down syndrome who was bullied and denied employment. So she created her own cookie company with her mom. Uh-huh. Now her cookies are sold in over 1,000 stores across the country.
Wow. Wait, so what are they?
They're called Coletti's Cookies. Here's Colette and her mom talking about the path to being a business owner.
I had no friends. I was bullied.
I wasn't really on the road of what Colette was working on, and I kind of threw her in it for the skills and that she could get that I wasn't able to teach her, and voila, a cookie monster was born. If you really want this, we're gonna sit down every day until this is done.
She can be very tough of me, but that's what mom's is for.
And I walked her through all the steps, and she did everything.
I did look up Coletti's Cookies. You can order them to be delivered if you want to support it. Yeah. And finally, an 84-year-old woman in Colorado, her name's Kim, 84. She has set a goal to skydive 1,000 times before she dies. She's already done about 600 jumps. Her first was back in 1959 when she was 20 years old. Then she took a 37-year break before taking it back up.
Took a lot of time off there.
At 84, she just did 3 more jumps the other day. She was just part of the national skydiving team. Here she is.
Did you ever lay on the ground and just watch birds flying around and watch how they stop and how they go and catch the wind currents and stuff? December 13, 1959, finally made my first jump. It was a long wait, but it was fun. It was worth it. And I was on the first U.S. women's team. And we won the gold. Standing under the American flag and hearing that national anthem, it's a big deal.
Isn't that great? There
that
you go.
So cool.
Yeah, and that, my friends, is good news for you.
What's poppin'?
Telling you all the fun stuff happening this weekend with What's Poppin'.
Oh, yeah.
What are you doing?
This weekend?
Yeah.
I want to say my neighborhood's having a big block party.
Oh, that's fun.
I think it's on Saturday. Maybe Friday.
Do you have to, like, manage something for that? Do you have to go work the cotton candy machine for a second?
No,
or the moon bounce?
I paid $10, okay. And then we rented a bunch of inflatables and stuff.
My community's been doing a lot of cool parties this summer, too. And
yeah,
I love
it. It's really fun.
Yeah, it makes you be like...
Because it's just like a bunch of families.
You know, it feels pure.
Yeah, old-timey.
Old-timey, yeah. My buddy's getting married tomorrow.
Zach was a part of 20 Days to 20 Days.
Yes, he was.
See, I'm a good... what's it called?
Good luck, Chuck.
Yeah, that's me.
You're pretty close. He went out on a date with you, then he met his fiance, soon-to-be wife, at Country Fan Fest.
You're welcome. I am a services community.
So we're going up to Heber tomorrow for a full day of festivities.
Oh, that is
going
to be so fun.
Yeah, the kids are excited, too. They're part of not part of the wedding, but they're invited to the wedding.
Right.
And, like, all the stuff. So, yeah, it's going to be fun. All right, but if you're not invited to Zach's wedding, here's some fun stuff for you to do.
I wasn't invited either. Don't be upset.
Comedian TJ Miller is playing Wise Guys this weekend. He was one of the voices in Big Hero 6.
Is he the brother?
He's the mascot.
Oh!
He was in Deadpool. He's Deadpool's
sidekick.
He's also,
wasn't he in the tech show?
He was on
Silicon Valley.
Yeah. So TJ Miller is at Wise Guys. Jax, who we play here on our station, is at Canyons tonight doing a concert.
That's cool.
Yeah. I want to go to this next event, but my kids just have not been as into it as me.
Wait. Is it the dinosaurs?
Yes.
I want to go to Jurassic Park Live so bad.
Jurassic World Live at the Delta Center all weekend. I want to go.
John, do you want to go together?
Yes.
Will you be my date?
I do, because I have brought it up to my kids, like, hey, you know, this kind of would be fun.
It could be cool, like animatronic dinos and stuff.
I want to see big dinosaurs walking around the Delta Center.
Sounds
amazing.
Me too. All right.
If anyone has tickets and they want to give them to Chantel and I, hook us up.
Yeah.
All about it. Golden Spike PRCA Rodeo at the Golden Spike Arena tomorrow and actually tonight and tomorrow as well. There you go. Lots of stuff happening. That, my friends, is What's Poppin'. After the whole Blindside controversy, Ranker did a list of the most inspirational sports movies that were out there.
Obviously, remember the Titans is number one.
Number two. I was just telling Jen how much I love that movie. Remember the Titans.
Who's number one? Remember, the Titans gave us Hayden Panettiere.
When I tell you number one, you'll be like, yeah, that makes sense.
Miracle?
Miracle was number four.
Okay.
Miracle is the one.
Hockey team.
The hockey one. It's great. And the Kurt Russell coach speech is fantastic. They play it like at all the Jazz games.
Right.
Blindside did make the list at number six.
Inspirational sports. Mighty Ducks.
Mighty Ducks did not make top 10.
What? Outrage.
Number 10 was 42, the Jackie Robinson story.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Number 9, We Are Marshall.
We Are Marshall.
Who stars in that?
Matthew McConaughey.
Yeah. Fighting With My Family at number 8, I think is...
I have no idea.
I think that's like about the Rock story. I could be wrong.
Rocky
made number 3 on this list. You're almost there. Number 7's Field of Dreams. I told you I've never seen it. Number
The
6,
Rookie.
The Rookie. Not on this. Oh,
all right. They don't like Texas. I get it.
Number 5, Hoosiers. That's great. Number 4, Miracle. Number 3, Rocky. Number 2, Remember the Titans. Any last guesses for number 1, the most inspirational sports movie ever?
Wait, give me a sport.
Football.
Football.
College football.
College football.
Sean Astin.
Oh, Rudy.
Rudy.
Eh.
It's fine.
Remember the Titans is better. We like talking movies.
Yeah, we do.
It's funny, though, because I haven't seen a lot of movies that are old, and you haven't seen a lot of movies that are new.
I know.
But I've got a list of the most overrated movies that we all just pretend to like, but like really, they're just overrated.
Let's do this.
Fight Club. Can't say Fight Club if you're in Fight Club or something like that.
So Fight Club came out when I was in high school. It was
a pretty
big, like, boy movie. We watched it a lot because it was like fighting and stuff. It's fine. I haven't seen it like as an adult, so I'd be curious to see if I loved it as much as like when we were in high school watching it.
The Notebook. That's not overrated.
I've told you my biggest problem.
It's fantastic.
I've told you. I don't like when the mom drives the daughter over.
Oh, to go see her.
To see the man.
True love working in the field.
I'm like, how messed up is that?
She's like, I liked him, but he was blue collar. We don't marry blue collar.
I feel like Rachel
McAdams.
You know why I think this is?
Allie.
I think Jen scrolls Instagram and then shows the kids like, see, this is the person I should have married. So I just feel like it's the same thing.
You're taking it personally.
Maybe so.
Jaws. I never saw it.
Jaws is great.
Chinatown.
I don't think it's overrated at all.
Never saw it.
Chinatown, it's a classic. I haven't seen it since college. I don't know if I would still be as... I bet it's boring now.
It's overrated. We just pretend to like it.
Movies that came out, if it's not within the last 10 years, movies were slow.
Slow.
That's why I'm shocked so many people saw Oppenheimer.
Yeah, because it was kind of old, huh?
Well, it's a very
the way
slow, dialogue-driven movie, yeah.
Yeah. Forrest Gump.
Really? I still love Forrest Gump.
I know. The Shining.
Well, it's not...
That is a long movie.
And it's not really, like, scary the way,
it's a
like,
thriller.
The Pope's Exorcist on Netflix is right now. Like, it's a different kind of scary... Yeah, it's slow. I still like it, though.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know. If I didn't like it, but if I watched it for the first time, I don't know if I'd be into it.
I watched it for the first time because I had to in college.
Okay.
And I was like, yeah, I get it. Here's Johnny.
Yeah.
But like, okay.
It's dad going crazy.
I know.
Yeah.
The poor dad going crazy.
You know what? I relate.
Bad first date? Getting ghosted? Stood up? Blocked again? Let John and Chantel help with their 7:30 second date update.
Going to West Valley as we say good morning to Jackie. Hi, Jackie.
Hey, hi, good morning. Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, of course. So what's going on with Patrick? He's ghosting you. It's been a while.
I really hope not. I just hope it's a misunderstanding.
So,
you know?
Yeah. Will you just tell me kind of what happened on the date?
Okay, we went to this cafe where they allow pets, so I brought my Fluffkins. And
wait, I'm sorry.
I thought everything.
Who's your Fluffkins?
Oh, I'm sorry. it's my dog Brady. He's my little Fluffkins.
Oh,
it's just his nickname.
Okay,
one of his nicknames.
So you brought your dog, Fluffkins,
Mr. Fluffkins,
to the restaurant. Yeah. So, what happened when Patrick got there?
No, we just had a little table, and we it was nice. He wasn't too busy, and we had coffee. We shared some little pastries. We had a great conversation. Everything was just wonderful, actually. And he seemed to like Brady. And most importantly, Brady liked him. And I just thought it was a good date.
Can I jump in here? So was this like planned? Like, did he bring his pet too? And it was like kind of like you bring your animals and like the whole thing?
No, it's not. It's not one of those pet cafes, but it was just. It's just open. You can bring your pet,
yeah.
And he doesn't have actually. Patrick doesn't have any pets, but hey, you know, no one's perfect, so he's still a catch without owning any pets yet.
Yeah.
So
okay.
So the date went well.
Yeah, I thought it did seem to be. I honestly can't think of anything that would have made him not want to call me.
Mm. Can I ask you a question? What did Fluffkins think of Patrick?
No, Fluffkins was very affectionate towards him. And if, you know, if people give a bad vibe, he's still sweet, but he isn't really interested in kind of cuddling up. So,
okay.
Yeah.
How long has it been since the date?
A little over 2 weeks.
Right there on the cusp of being too long. Yeah. Okay, let's play a song. Let's get Patrick's number from you off air, and we will call him up, and we'll see if we can get to the bottom of this, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Hello?
Hey, is this Patrick?
Yeah, it is. Who's calling?
Patrick, what's up, man? My name is John. Chantel's with me.
Hi.
The two of us, we do a morning radio show and a podcast in Salt Lake. It's on Mix 105.1. In fact, we're hoping we could talk to you about a date that you had with Jackie. It's almost been 2 weeks, Patrick.
Oh, yeah. Okay,
yeah?
Sure.
Okay, cool. It's something our show does. It's called the Second Date Update. Really, what we're wondering is why you haven't called Jackie back.
Okay, well, she's not my type.
Not your type. What do you mean by that?
I don't know. She's just, she was really into her dog.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
I kind of got that, like, talking to her a little bit.
Yeah.
But how so? Like, what do you mean, like, too into her dog?
Because it can't be that bad. I mean, everyone loves her, you know, their fur baby.
Right. I mean, she brought the dog on the date.
Yeah, like, as soon as she said that, I was like, red flag. Not, I love pets.
You used to bring your dog everywhere.
No, I know, but I would ask, like, if it was a date, I'd be like, hey, is it okay if I bring my dog? Did she ask if she could bring her dog on the date?
She didn't mention it. I mean, it's not like it was a huge problem, but she did dress the dog up in a suit as well.
I'm sorry. Hold on a second. Like a suit?
Yeah, it had a vest and a tie.
And a dog suit.
Okay.
Yep.
Perfectly normal. I hear nothing wrong with this so far, Patrick.
No. Did the dog get scraps off the table?
No, thank God.
Okay, so you didn't have to order the dog a meal.
No, okay. But she did keep bringing the conversation back to the dog. Yeah. It was like, I get it. You have a dog.
Okay.
Can we talk about something else?
Patrick, I appreciate you telling us this side of the story. We kind of had a vibe it might have gone this way.
Yeah.
Jackie's actually on the other line. Would you mind us spending just a few minutes talking together?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, cool. Hey, Jackie.
Hey.
Hey.
Hi, John. I love my dog. He's my little buddy. I just don't understand why I'm not allowed to talk about him.
I just thought we could talk about other things a little, because it was our first date.
I mean, we did talk about everything. I didn't realize I talked about my baby that much. I was so nervous. I was super nervous, actually. And when I get nervous, Brady calms me down. And he's like my emotional support doggy.
I get that.
So,
would you be able to go to other places and not bring him along?
Oh, yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. I mean, this was our first date, and I just felt a little more comfortable bringing Brady because... You know, he's always there for me when I need him, and because he is so chill, he helps me relax, and that's all.
The impression that I got was that you couldn't do anything without him.
Oh, no. I can definitely go places without him. I do it all the time. I didn't mean to freak you out.
You know, can I jump in, Patrick? Because what I'm hearing is, I get it, like, Jackie was nervous on this date. She brought something she feels comfortable with. And then when you're nervous, what do? You just keep referencing the one thing. So to me, it sounds like that's what was going on. Like, looking back now as we hear Jackie's point of view from the date, like, how does that sound to you, Patrick?
I mean, I didn't realize you were nervous, Jackie. I don't think anyone's ever been nervous meeting me. So that makes a lot of sense.
I mean, I was. Oh, my gosh. I don't go on a lot of dates, but I'm not nervous anymore. I felt a connection. I'd like to try again if you're interested.
I mean, I would like to try again.
Second date, we'll pay for the whole thing. No dog this time. Leave Fluffkins at home. What do we say?
I say yes. Let's do it.
Morning, Mercedes.
Hi, good morning.
What's up?
I mean, I didn't even know who to call about this. I needed to tell somebody.
Okay.
My son is in Davis County School District, so we haven't even been in a week yet, and he's already been in the principal's office.
No, Mercedes, I'm sorry. Oh,
I know.
No.
I know.
How old is he?
He's in the fourth grade.
Okay. How'd it happen?
So, he and his buddy were wrestling at recess, and then the wrestling got too real, and they started fighting, and my son bit his friend.
Mm.
He bit him. by this point, the yard person was over there, and they went to the principal's office, and he brought home a note that I had to sign, and just like, this is already going to be a year, you know?
Oh, yeah. Within the first week, it's never a good way to start anything. Oh,
no.
I'm so sorry.
No, it's not. Thank you.
Let's see if anyone else. I mean, Mercedes just called in. It's been only a week. Whose kid has already been called in the principal's office outside of Mercedes' son, who's in fourth grade? In the son's defense, he was just wrestling with his buddy, and then it got too far.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It wasn't he was bullying or anything like that. I did get a text saying that my son was transferred to another class already. That's not a good start.
Oh, no.
I want to know more. Like, what happened there? Was it the teacher? Did the teacher request?
Yeah, that's crazy.
Or, yeah. You ever hear of screen apnea?
Like, being on your phone screen makes it so you can't sleep?
No. That's a good, so you know what sleep apnea is, right?
Yeah.
Well, the New York Times just did this big write-up on screen apnea. So it's like sleep apnea, where you stop breathing in your sleep, except it happens when you're too focused on your screen. So you don't stop breathing altogether, but you might somehow be holding your breath without realizing it, or maybe you're just breathing really shallow. It started in 2007. This Microsoft exec named Linda, she realized she was doing it, and she actually coined the term email apnea.
Email apnea?
Yeah, and they ended up using it all around Microsoft, but it's really become screen apnea because of social media.
Yeah.
Microsoft did this whole report. They tracked 200 other people looking at their phone, and they found out that 80% sometimes held their breath or altered their breathing while looking at their phone.
I believe it.
Isn't that crazy to think, though? They're saying it's our body's stress response to any kind of stimuli, and it's our nervous system kicking into gear when there's a threat. So you're afraid of what someone's going to write,
yep,
or you're reading something that's causing you some anxiety, and so you're holding your breath while you're scrolling soon, and it's destroying what we're doing. Emails, texts, Slack messages, Instagram, Facebook, they did it on all of these, and it sends our body into a, quote, chronic state of threat. And they're saying one way to get rid of it is if you catch yourself holding your breath, sigh out loud. Like that.
I'm just going to be sitting at my desk, and I'll hear John.
I'll be at Chick-fil-A inside. Just
Oh, no.
It's Friday, which means it is time to figure out where you're going to eat tonight. And fear not, we got you covered. That's why we talked to our friend Chase from the Instagram account SLC Foodie. In fact, our conversation brought to you by Penny Ann's Cafe, home of the Heavenly Hotcakes, light and airy sour cream pancakes. What up, Chase?
Hey.
Dude, I love when you have ramen on your list because my family, we are ramen fanatics.
You guys really are.
We are.
Perfect. Well, it's becoming ramen weather.
Yes. My son says on the first day of snow, we're supposed to go get ramen. And I'm like, I'm fine with that more than in the middle of July when it was 106 and he wanted ramen. I'm like, dude, stop it.
I love it. He's smart.
So where are we going to?
Ramen Garden. So this spot just opened up. It's in Syracuse and Clearfield. Both spots opened up at the same time. But the neat thing about it is it's locally owned. So it's a little bold. When a restaurant does two at a time and they're local, you know their ramen's going to be good.
Absolutely. Yeah. Did you have a favorite?
So I really enjoyed the miso ramen. I had that the first visit. But I wanted to, of course, it was hot when I went. So I did the dry ramen, and I was blown away by that. They basically get rid of the broth, but it was delicious.
So wait, is it a noodle dish then?
Yeah, it literally dump the broth out, and you have dry ramen. It's perfect because when it's hot, I don't really want to fill my stomach with a bunch of hot water.
You know, when I was in college and all we ate was ramen noodles, I would sometimes take just the noodles out because it was something different than the broth.
Yeah, I'd always strain the broth out.
Yeah, I didn't realize that was actually a thing.
Oh.
Dry ramen.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, and they do this, it's kind of like a ground pork on top of spicy ground pork. It was really good, and the portion was huge.
We're talking about Ramen Garden, Syracuse, and Clearfield, two locations. Did they have anything besides the noodles?
Yeah, if you want a rice bowl, they had a teriyaki chicken rice bowl. They had a teriyaki beef bowl, and it literally was legit steak. I mean, it had to be like New York strip or something. It wasn't like baby strips of anything.
Mm, okay, that's Ramen Garden. Let's go over to South Jordan. What restaurants over there today?
So, Angry Korean. So, I went to the Cottonwood Heights location, really enjoyed it, and they said, you got to check out South Jordan. It has a different menu. So, I went, and it's kind of like the menu's a Mexican-Korean fusion, more so over there than the Cottonwood Heights location.
Okay. Oh, interesting.
I'm glad you said something, because when you said you wanted to talk Angry Korean again, I'm like, wait, we already did Angry Korean, but each location has a different menu.
Yeah, which is interesting, right?
Yeah.
So this one, the location's bigger, so they have more prep area, so they can do more menu items. So they have things like bulgogi tacos, right? That's like, you know, the stuff you'd get in your Korean bowl, the beef, but it's in a taco. So it's that blend of both sides. Like chicken quesadillas. They even had wings.
What a weird place.
Yeah, like fusion of different types of foods.
I know, right? And I love it because the name of the restaurant, right? Angry Korean. So people go there, they're like, this isn't Korean food. And he's like, yeah, I know. It's fusion. It's what I like. I'm the Angry Korean.
He's like, don't make me angry. All right, so that's called the Angry Korean. It's in South Jordan. Of course, the other Angry Korean, it's in Cottonwood Heights, right?
Yes.
We'll get both locations up on our website as well at mix1051utah.com. Chase, if someone wants to learn more about you and your Instagram account, how should they do so?
Yeah, SLC Foodie on Instagram or TikTok, and Salt Lake Foodie on Facebook.
It's Friday. A freaky Friday, Chantel.
Oh, gosh. Are haunted houses open?
No, I don't mean that kind of freaky.
Oh, dear.
Hey, girl.
Hey.
On a scale of 1 to America, how free are you tonight?
That could go a lot of different ways,
fine.
John. I've got more movies that we all pretend to like, but really they're just overrated.
I love this list.
Ah. I like a lot of these movies, though.
I just knocked my mouse all the way across the way.
Oh, jeez.
I'm sorry. Go ahead,
'kay.
Please.
Avatar. It's an art piece. People love it. People hate it.
I like Avatar, but Avatar is one of those movies I only need to watch once. I've never been like, oh, I want to watch Avatar again. First of all, they're like 4 hours long.
Right.
Like I saw the new one, the sequel on Disney Plus. I'm like, there's no way in the heck I'm going to sit down and watch that thing.
Yeah. The Greatest Showman. That we actually like that. That's not overrated at all.
I love The Greatest Showman. I love the music in it.
Everything. What's his name? Zac Efron.
Zendaya.
Right? Didn't they date for a second after or no?
Did they? I don't think so.
Good, because he's mine.
I'm pretty sure.
She's not married. He's not married.
No, he's not married. You're right.
But of course he has a girlfriend.
Yeah.
His name's Zac Efron. I've loved him since Troy Bolton. Frozen.
It's good.
Don't say it's overrated and we pretend to like it. It's good.
I think it's just...
It's overplayed.
Yeah, because if you grew up with a child in that time, but right. Every kind of movie is like over.
It is unfortunate,
like
though, the movies like that that blow up are traditionally like princess movies. I feel bad when my kids are like, I want to, not the gender, whatever.
Go ahead.
I'm already going to get whatever. Canceled. I'm just saying, like, my son loves Frozen. He wants to get, like, Elsa toys and stuff, and we buy him and, you know, whatever.
Yeah,
but
I
understand
what you're saying.
I really wish that there was more than Woody and Buzz.
For, when it comes to cartoons.
When it comes to blockbuster.
Yeah, I'm trying to think right now.
Movies for boys.
Gosh, the last few ones
Disney.
Have been so terrible. You know what I mean? Like, the last few.
And what is the last blockbuster Disney movie that is, like, gender neutral boys?
I don't remember.
Toy Story?
Maybe.
Toy
I'd
Story
have to
4?
Look up and go through the list. Marvel?
No, I don't do the superheroes.
Well, maybe it's time to start doing it. Your kids would love them.
No, they can watch. They
your
watch them.
Your boys.
No, they watch them. Oh, we watch them at home. I don't do the superheroes.
No, you don't.
So, like, I'm the one with the credit card.
Yeah.
We're not buying the superhero shirts. Right. Anyway. The Silence of the Lambs.
That's a great movie. And I saw it within the last 5 years.
Do
it
we
holds
pretend
up.
To like it? Or
no.
Is it actually good?
I think it's a really good thriller. I think that it's been overplayed with, like, some of the clips. So now it feels overplayed. But it's a fantastic film.
Star Wars Episode 6, Return of the Jedi.
So that was the...
Doesn't it go 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3?
Yes. So this was the last of the original trilogy.
Yes, it was 83.
I thought it was good. I don't know. I mean, I like Star Wars.
Honestly,
like
they all blend together for me.
Yeah, I always enjoy them, but I'm not like a huge Star Wars
I don't think
fan.
It's overrated. No. And then Avengers Infinity War.
We've talked before about how the Avengers movies, to me, they started getting too long. The storylines are all over the place. I get it with all the timelines.
Tell me, well, this isn't a best movies. This is a overrated movie,
yeah.
So I guess it does work.
What?
As a number one.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But if you want best, it's those freaking Guardians of the Galaxy. They just get it.
Yes. They know who they are.
They just get it.
I want to rewatch the one that we did the screening for.
Yeah.
It just came out, I think, on Disney Plus. Oh, I'm like,
so
yes,
good.
Give me some of that. Things that make you. Things that make you go. Things that make you go. Got to do a fun fact. It's called Things That Make You Go,
Mm-hmm.
The Nintendo character Kirby is named after an attorney named John Kirby, who successfully defended Nintendo in court when they were being sued by Universal, who said Donkey Kong was a ripoff of King Kong. So Universal Pictures, they were suing Nintendo, saying,
yeah.
Hey, that Donkey Kong character, that's a ripoff of our King Kong. And John Kirby was like, not in my courthouse.
Oh.
And then he ended up defending Nintendo and winning.
For those like me who weren't quite sure who Kirby was, he's the pink circle like figure.
You never played Kirby?
No.
He would eat things up.
Nah.
I want to be named after something iconic. Like when you hear stories like that, I think that's so cool.
Kirby came out in 1992.
There's still Kirby video games today, though. Like those updated Kirby video games. It's not. You're not in the video game world yet.
I'm not.
Give it a few more years.
Mm.
You'll be there.
Mm.
Your kids will be sneaking off trying to hang out with people who do have video
games.
They
already do.
All right. That does it for us. Bye-bye.